Hello, gorgeous Pisces. Welcome to your yearly reading for 2022. I hope everyone is doing really well. Let's take a look at your cards and the messages that Spirit would like to bring through for the year ahead. This is a general reading, remember, so please take what resonates for you personally and just leave the rest. And be sure to check in with your own intuition to interpret the meanings of the cards for you and your personal situation. That's how you'll get the best, the most out of this reading. So let's see, Pisces, your first two cards, motivation and nurture. Motivation kindles the passion and energy needed in working toward your goals. So having motivation to do what it is that you want to do in this coming year, it's surrounding you. You might not have to fight for motivation. You might not have to struggle for motivation. Perhaps that's been the case over the past year. You're going to be working toward your goal, slowly but surely toward your goals. It might be more than one goal, but whatever goals that you are setting for the year ahead, you will have the determination, you'll have the motivation to get up and go and to move with this energy and do what needs to be done. So this is nice. It's a really great energy to have. And there's an energy of nurture. So you're nurturing a certain aspect of your life, nurturing, perhaps you'll be learning new things. You might be nurturing a child, perhaps. You might be nurturing your work or your family life or your relationships. Okay, wherever your motivation lies, whatever your intention is, Pisces, that's what Spirit is talking about here. That's what you'll be nurturing. And it's important to you. It's emotionally important to you. So it says on this card, nurturing your inner child supplies you with the innocent joy of living. So I really like this card for you, Pisces, because I'm seeing that there is a joy of living that's coming back. There's a sense of inspiration and joy, lightheartedness. So if your heart has been heavy recently, know that this new year is a breath of fresh air. Yeah, a breath of fresh air, Pisces. I love it. You are going to be rewarded for focus. You know, you are going to be rewarded for focus and sticking with something. So we have gratitude, and this is the heart chakra. And we also have another heart chakra energy. So it's all about the heart. It's all about your connection to others from the heart, opening up your heart, healing from past hurts, and opening up this energy in a powerful way. There's gratitude and there's harmony. I am thankful and humble as I move through life. I receive willingly, lovingly, and graciously. I recognize and appreciate the small things in life, the synchronicities and beauty that can be found in each and every moment. Yeah, I love that. You're looking at the little things in life. You're looking at the beauty in what you have. You are setting yourself up for success. That's what I'm receiving. That's the message I'm receiving here from Spirit, Pisces. This next year is you setting yourself up for ultimate success. And it starts small. You recognize the small things. You appreciate the small things. And you're noticing more and more synchronicities happening. My mind, body, and spirit work in harmony with each other, aligned with both my will and the divine will. And this is powerful. When your will is connected in with the divine will, that powerful stuff happens. There are going to be some powerful shifts happening, Pisces, because this is happening, because your will, your willpower is in alignment with divine will. I have balance in my life with room for both pleasure and purpose. My giving and receiving of love and abundance are in perfect balance. I am balanced. Beautiful. Okay, let's see what this deck reveals for you, Pisces. Guidance for Pisces, please, Spirit. Guidance for Pisces. Okay, these two cards here at the top. Be without malice. Be without malice. You don't need to hold on to this feeling, this emotion. You don't need to hold on to any kind of malice, any kind of ill intent, any negative vibrations or energies that have been hounding you, that have been around you, that have been present in your life from others. That's very possible. A lot of the negative energies come from other people in our lives. And so you don't need to hold on to this. You can be without it. You can say no. You can put up some boundaries. You can be without this energy. Seek your answers within. So I'm seeing a lot of meditation. I'm seeing meditation. I'm seeing going within. I'm seeing a spiritual practice. Seek your answers within. You will receive the answers. You will receive the guidance. You will receive the guidance. But it's about taking time out to allow this to happen, to sit and to listen to what your heart, it's interesting that your heart can see here. Your heart can see the truth, Pisces. Yeah. Guidance of Pisces. This card here, there is a spiritual awakening and confirmation. Okay. Spiritual awakening, your higher vibrations rise from within. Your spiritual path is calling you. So this year is going to be extremely powerful for getting onto your spiritual path, getting onto the path that is right for you. You might be feeling at the moment that you're at a crossroads. You might be feeling very soon into the new year that you're at a crossroads and you're having to make some big decisions in life. Know that this is part of your spiritual awakening and that your path, your true path, your aligned path is calling you, and that's why you're having to make some decisions and choices. Yes, okay. Confirmation. Ask those desired questions. Open your heart and receive the signs from above. So you will definitely receive confirmation from spirit, from God, from source energy, from your angels and guides, from your loved ones in spirit. Confirmation will come through. I feel it's very much connected to this card here. Seek your answers within. Your heart knows the answer. Your heart is going to see the answers. You will, if you ask the questions, they will be answered. You're going to receive guidance in a powerful way, in a known way. It's not going to pass you by, that's for sure. Okay, let's see what this deck reveals for you, Pisces. Let's take the center card. This one here. Death, a big energy, an energy of transformation, an energy of shedding your old skin, shedding an old you, an old version, and you've outgrown this version of you. It's showing the awakening. It's showing this spiritual awakening. But you have to let go of the past, or you have to let go of certain feelings. You have to let go of some malice or some negative vibrations. You have to understand that they were there at a particular point, at a particular time, for a particular reason, but you don't need them anymore. And it's about shedding that, letting go of these things so you can awaken to a new, I want to say a new heart-centered, because we've got these two heart chakra cards, a new heart-centered way of feeling and thinking and being. Wow. So the Ace of Wands. Now, this indicates that there is some new action, a newness coming in, a new passion, a new interest, a new hobby, a new learning. Something new is going to take place. Might be learning about health or learning about your well-being. Might be learning about relationships in a deeper way, perhaps. One or all of those things might resonate. Might be different. Might be a different thing. But yes, there's definitely a new beginning. that you're initiating, and it's to do with what you're wanting to accomplish. It's to do with motivation, you know, it's to do with you accomplishing new things and moving into new successes. New rewards are coming your way in the year ahead. The Queen of Pentacles. Okay, so this is someone around you, someone who is close to you, someone might be your partner, it might be your family member, but this is someone around you who is, I feel, quite supportive of you. I feel they have your back. I feel they are there for you. They're quite grounded. They're grounded. They're there for you. They're like your rock. Perhaps you know who this person is, but perhaps you can't quite work out who this person is. Perhaps you don't have someone in your life like this. And if that's the case, Pisces, do not worry, because this person is in spirit. This may be a spirit guide for you. This may be an angel around you, or your higher self. So that's for you to check in with your intuition and work out who this person is, or who this being is, because they are there. They are there, they're present, and they are anchoring you, is what I'm seeing. The Nine of Pentacles, great energy for being comfortable, or more comfortable than you have been over the past year, materially in some way. It might be financially, or your possessions, what you have in your home, might be a new home, might be renovations, might be investments. But it's an energy of being very comfortable in a material sense. Health as well comes into play here with Pentacles. So health, very comfortable in your body, mentally, emotionally, physically, especially physically with that card. And the Knight of Swords. Okay, so you're going to be using your brain power, which is interesting, because you're coming from a heart centered place, but you're using your mind. So this can often reflect to you being educated. So you might be doing some kind of learning in the new year, some kind of learning, formal learning perhaps, but you're definitely thinking about things in a quicker way. You're remembering things in a more accurate way. Your communication mentally and your communication with others, whether it's written or verbal, it's on point. And I'll also say with this card, the Knight of Swords can be a very swift energy. So changes that are going to happen in the new year are going to happen in a fast way, swift way. Things will happen quite fast. If there things start to change for you in an area of your life, expect them to change quite suddenly. Okay, so it's a fast energy happening there, but you're going to stay centered in your heart, and that's the most important thing here. I see some wonderful cards and energy surrounding you for the year ahead. So Pisces, I hope that this reading's been helpful for you. I hope that Spirit has spoken to you and you've received the messages that Spirit want to bring through for you at this time. Stay blessed, Pisces, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.